Today we will study the method used to confirm a hypothesis. We know that verification of hypothesis is used to confirm a hypothesis. Verification of hypothesis consists in finding out whether the hypothesis agrees with the facts of nature or not. If it agrees with the facts of nature, then it is said to be valid and confirmed, and it is accepted. If it does not agree with the facts of nature, then it is said to be invalid or disconfirmed, and it is either modified or rejected. Verification can be done either directly or indirectly. Let us see direct verification. Hypothesis that is verified directly is called empirical or instantial hypothesis. It consists in observing. Direct verification consists in observing the facts to which the hypothesis refers. When a hypothesis is confirmed directly, there is hardly any doubt about its truth. But very few hypotheses in science are verified directly. Direct verification is either done by observation or experiment. When actual observation shows that the things referred in the hypothesis are actually found existing, then it is called direct verification by observation. Let us take an example, discovery of Neptune. In this, the hypothesis put forward was that there is another planet beyond Uranus which was disturbing the orbit of Uranus and its gravitational force. This hypothesis could be verified directly by observing the new planet through the Berlin's telescope. Now, when the hypothesis is verified by experiment in the laboratory, it is called as direct verification by experiment. In the case of pandemic, a hypothesis was put forward that homeopathic medicine can prevent coronavirus. An experiment was conducted. Some people who were quarantined were given arsenic album 30, that is homeopathic medicine, while the others were given allopathic medicine. Then the people were observed whether they had developed COVID-19. The doctors found that those who had consumed the homeopathic medicine did not develop the symptoms. Hence, the hypothesis that homeopathic medicine can prevent coronavirus was confirmed directly by performing an experiment. Now we see that there are most of the scientific hypotheses cannot be verified directly because they deal with unobservable entities such as electrons, protons, gravitation, electromagnetic waves, etc. Such hypotheses are called theoretical or non-instantial hypotheses, and they have to be verified indirectly. So, indirect verification consists in deducing the consequences from the hypothesis and testing those consequences by appeal to facts. This means there are two steps involved in indirect verification. The first is deductive development of hypothesis, that is, certain consequences are predicted. Second, finding out whether these predicted consequences really take place. If the predicted consequences are true, the hypothesis is said to be verified indirectly. Indirect verification can be done by observation or by experiment. Let us take an example of Kon-Tiki expedition. The group of sociologists had observed that there are certain similarities between the ancient traditions of natives of South Sea Islands and the inhabitants of South America. So the problem was felt that how could this be possible as both the places were far apart from each other. Hence, a hypothesis was formulated by the sociologists that natives of South Sea Islands came from South America. this hypothesis appeared impossible because that 1000 years ago these primitive people could have undertaken a journey of several months was little unbelievable. So it was not possible in those days because boats were not available probably. From the hypothesis, the scientists deduced that a primitive boat must be capable of undertaking such a journey. The consequences were tested and the scientists undertook a trip in such a boat under the prevailing conditions, which carried them to the destination, and the sociologist arrived on the islands, say after over 100 days they reached, but they were successful. So this hypothesis was verified indirectly by both observation and experiment. Now we come to the limits of verification. Verification shows that C is the cause of E, but does not show that C is the only cause of E. If the verification of hypothesis is identified with its proof, then it commits the fallacy of affirming the consequent. That is, if hypothesis H is true, then its consequences C1, C2, C3 take place. Consequences C1, C2, C3 take place. Therefore, the hypothesis H is true. Whereas when the hypothesis is proved and established, it is the only solution to the problem. That means certainty. It is if and only if hypothesis H, then the consequences C1, C2, C3 take place. The consequences C1, C2, C3 take place. Therefore, the hypothesis H is true. But no hypothesis can be exhaustively confirmed. This is because the observation in science is never complete. So we have studied in this part of the chapter hypothesis, what is the method to confirm the hypothesis, that is the verification method and its types and limits. Thank you.